Well, Danscore is the premier concert of the year. And I say the premier, there are two big concerts. But this concert represents what it is that we actually train dancers to do in the profession. It's a contemporary dance concert. All the students have to audition, and only the best are selected.
Danscore is the name given to the annual faculty concert, the faculty choreographed concert in the Department of Dance. Some time ago, Danscore was a corps of dancers, C-O-R-E, corps of dancers, who not only performed here in Hartwell Theater, but also represented the college and the Department of Dance on tour throughout Western New York.
Danscore is the faculty research concert, so there's not an inclusive theme that runs from one dance to the next. It's really each faculty member having the opportunity to present them their work, their choreography for the Brockport community and the Rochester community, and an opportunity to involve the students in their research.
The piece is full of color, which is what I saw a lot of in Africa. It's a piece that's about sisterhood and connecting, and most of all, remembering your roots, whatever they may be. The cast is very multicultural, a variety of ethnic backgrounds and ages. I have sophomores through graduate students in the piece. They went through a process of sharing about themselves and about their role models as women. And there was a tremendous amount of preparation for them to find their inner womanhood, as I would like to call it. And they came a long way, and they helped me to pull this piece together to what it is. And I'm very proud of them.
It started out really with the idea of the haiku that are used in the piece. I was doing a lot of work with haiku in my composition classes when I was doing the Laban efforts, because they seem to really stimulate dancers to think metaphorically and to think in ways other than what steps they're going to do next. They were working a lot with energy and the ideas behind the words. So I was developing the haiku and just started to get, you know, an idea that it would be really wonderful to do a piece of haiku strung together, because all of the results of stuff in the composition classes were so beautiful.
Degrees, that's a perfect turnout. Knees braced dangerously.
As a person who came to dance with a much more athletic perspective on the world, when I started taking a lot of ballet and trying to understand ballet technique, it's a very interesting world. And it's also very interesting anatomically how it works and how some dancers get it and some dancers don't. And so it's really just about how difficult turnout can be for somebody who isn't born or bred for ballet.
Most of it is actually done improvisationally. I allow my mind to just drift and go through stream of conscious and recall imagery from that time. And then I connected it to other things from this area, actually, which were some of the kind of snow cyclones that you see out in the broad fields in the middle of the winter as the wind is whipping the snow around in the area. And that coldness, that frozen feeling, coupled with the feeling of the frozen stone that I saw when I was traveling in Italy, have just really struck me over the last few months. And that's why I started working with that in a dance. I think I had a kind of an idea of something becoming what it is to become flash frozen. What would happen if something just instantaneously froze in this space while it was going through the action of movement. And that was one idea that I was working with. The colors of blue and white, obviously blue is a cold color, and the white is just pulling from the idea of snow.
It's been wonderful. It's such an honor to be here, because prior to coming to this place, I've heard a lot about this dance department. It's widely, and I should put it this way, well respected. And so it was a very good thing for me to come, and it's been wonderful. What we do, we love what we do. So by presenting it, it just comes natural to me when I'm on stage. I just love to do that.
If you're a person at my age, you don't adjust real well to lights. So I have to spend the whole first part of the show just being back here with all these glaring lights.
Get your things on and go right to bed this minute. I'll be right now. You want to get a little warm, Jackie? All right, this is for you. Three little kittens, they lost their living.
I was determined that I would not dance to a piece of music, to recorded music. We were trying real hard in this concert to use live music, and I was not interested in making a dance to a piece of music. I was more interested in working with sound as rhythm and expression and, in finding something that was meaningful to me other than simply working with music as the motivation.
They lost their living, and they began to cry. Oh, mother dear, we badly fear our little mittens we have lost. What lost your mittens, you naughty kittens, and you shall have no pie.
I'm almost blind without my glasses, so I am going to be dancing half blind.
There's the little turtle. There was a little turtle.
I hope it expresses some universal feelings and relationships and about life. And what the style of dance is less important to me than the way movement and concept are woven together.
This is a piece that I choreographed in 1979 as part of a full evening work for my company, my professional company, which was based in Seattle at that time. And I excerpted two small sections from that full evening work and called it Craps and took it on tour with my company all throughout the United States for several years. And I've restaged this work on five of our most skilled dancers in the department, dance majors, two graduate students, three undergraduates, two of them seniors, one a junior. And it's a piece that requires tremendous physical courage and stamina and energy and a highly developed skill.
So, and it's pushed, the students are pushed maybe a little bit beyond their barrier, but they always seem to reach it. So that it's a connecting force between academic learning and professional life. So it's the high point, I would say, one of the high points of the year for us, and definitely the high point of the semester.